Dugout News YouTube channel is what you're watching. Welcome aboard. I got some new news for you concerning His Excellency Turki Alalshikh and Tyson Fury, Anthony Joshua, Oleksandr Usyk. His Excellency Turki Alalshikh will make an offer for the Tyson Fury versus Anthony Joshua, regardless of the result in the Oleksandr Usyk Tyson Fury rematch. He says we'll be making an offer for a fight to be made between Anthony Joshua and Tyson Fury. Now, for starters, you got this feeling that His Excellency is desperately in need of seeing this fight happen between Anthony Joshua and Tyson Fury. I think one of the major intentions of the Riyadh seasons, one of the top most wishes for His Excellency Turki Alalshikh was always a fight between Anthony Joshua and Tyson Fury. He loves it, even without the belts. He just loves it. Now, he says and insists he will push for the Tyson Fury versus Anthony Joshua a fight, even if the Gypsy King, that is Tyson Fury, loses to Oleksandr Usyk once more. Boxing fans have come or have been clamoring to see the long-awaited domestic dust-up for the last 5 years, but despite numerous attempts to get it over the line, nothing has come to fruition as of yet. If Joshua defeats Daniel Dubois, which you thinking that with His Excellency Turki Alalshikh thinking of the Joshua Daniel Dubois fight, and only talking about the rematch between Oleksandr Usyk and Tyson Fury, you feel that he already has his thoughts fixed on who he sees winning the Daniel Dubois Anthony Joshua fight, and that is Anthony Joshua. So if Joshua defeats Daniel Dubois on September 21st for the IBF title, and Fury overcomes WBA, WBC and WBO champion Usyk in their rematch 3 months later, then the British rivals will square off for the undisputed crown. But Turki Alalshikh insists that even when the Gypsy King loses, he doesn't talk of if Anthony Joshua loses to Daniel Dubois. Maybe they are underestimating Daniel Dubois, but it is a huge test for Anthony Joshua. Fury missed out on becoming the first undisputed heavyweight champion of the four belt era in May when he dropped a split decision to Usyk. There were fears that if the same happened again, then Joshua versus Fury would be cast to the boxing wastelands. However, His Excellency Turki Alalshikh has informed the world that he intends to make the fight regardless of the result of Usyk versus Fury. For the business, of course, it will be a huge fight if Joshua wins, he says. He also says his third time winning a world title, and after the result of Usyk and Fury, it will be a huge fight. But you don't know about the future. Imagine Tyson, after the fight with Usyk, wants to retire. I will give him the offer, but if he refuses, what can I do? First of all, Dubois has a very big chance, and it is not easy. I think it is a difficult fight for Joshua and a dangerous fight for Joshua. Now, if Fury wins, still I want to see Fury versus Joshua. Rather, if Usyk wins, still I want to see a Fury versus Joshua. If they accept, I will not try to do the third fight between Usyk and Joshua before having Fury and Joshua. If I think Joshua will win against Dubois, but you don't know what can happen in that squared circle. I picked Deontay Wilder against Joseph Parker and Zilei Zhang, and he lost. This is boxing, especially the heavyweights. But I want to see Fury versus Joshua, and the world wants to see Fury versus Joshua. That is His Excellency Turki Alalshikh insisting that he wants to see the Joshua versus Fury fight. Well, any boxing fan will clamor for this. There's been that long on and off good relationship between Anthony Joshua and Tyson Fury. Anthony Joshua came up a little bit late in the pros. While Tyson Fury, when he failed to make it to the Olympics, he right away moved to make his mark in the pros. Anthony Joshua came in later on, and he has continued to make history. So has Tyson Fury. Tyson Fury beating up, or being the man that beat up the man, beating up on Vladimir Klitschko, and after going into semi-retirement, coming back and winning that WBC belt from Deontay Wilder. Anthony Joshua has since lost out on his belts, but beat up on Vladimir Klitschko, went on to clinch more and more titles in there. Unified champion he was, then lost first his belts to Ander Ruiz, reclaimed them in the rematch in Saudi Arabia. That can be taunted as the first Riyadh season about, if I may use that word, Riyadh season. Then went on to defend against the likes of Kubrat Pulev and the likes, but he had to face his mandatory. That was Oleksandr Usyk at the time. They went in those two fights. Usyk won both of them. And well, Anthony Joshua is beltless currently. So he can win himself a belt against Daniel Dubois if he beats him up, and then wait for the winner between Fury and Oleksandr Usyk. That is what we are all waiting. But no matter the result, His Excellency Turki Alalshikh says if Joshua wins against Dubois, then whoever wins between Fury and Usyk, it doesn't matter. He will have to make that all-British affair fight between Anthony Joshua and Tyson Fury. This will be interesting. Hopefully, we do get to see it come all earlier next year. But what do you think of all this? Place your comment in the comment section below. I sign out. Peace.